Hi everyone, Kevin here. Today I want to show you how you can recover deleted files on a Windows 10 PC. Yes, it is possible, and probably the reason you're watching this video today is because you need to recover a file. Don't worry, I got your back. We're going to get your file back. It's happened to me before where I've deleted files and then I empty my recycle bin and I thought I was out of luck, but I wasn't. There's a way to get those files back. Now today, I have a USB stick with some critical files on it that I would absolutely not want to lose. So what are we going to do? Well, for the sake of this tutorial and to help out, I'm going to go ahead and delete those files and then we'll go ahead and recover them. At least I better be able to recover them. Just a quick word on what it even means to delete a file. When you delete a file, it doesn't actually get rid of it. It doesn't disappear. It's still right where it was. All you're doing is you're telling the system that you can now overwrite this space on the hard drive or on the USB stick. And until you overwrite it, that file still exists and you can recover it. That's why time is of the essence. The quicker you can recover a file, the more likely you are to be able to recover it. There are many different tools that help you recover files. I'm going to show you my favorite tool today. It turns out that Windows also has a recovery tool, but that's not the one that I'm going to be showing you because it doesn't work that well. We're going to use a third-party app today called Recuva. All right, enough talk. Let's get on the PC and let's recover some files. Here I am on my Windows 10 PC and I've inserted my USB drive into my computer. And here you can see all of the contents. Now, before you laugh and say, really, this is critical content, I just see pictures of cookies. This is strategic information for my company, the Kevin Cookie Company. In fact, I have a Word document on how the company is going to become a unicorn. If you don't know what a unicorn is, that's a company that's worth at least $1 billion. This is a very detailed plan for how we are going to pull that off for the Kevin Cookie Company. So no matter what, I would not want to lose this. There's so much brainstorming and thought that went into this document. All right, well, back to the tutorial. I want to delete some files and we'll see if we can get them back. So let me just delete these files right here and I should be able to recover them. I really, really need to be able to recover them. So let's go ahead, let's delete these files. It says, are you sure you want to permanently delete these 8 items? Well, I mean, I don't really want to permanently delete them. I mean, I do want them back, but let's click yes for now. So I deleted these files and there's nothing in the recycle bin either. So these files are now good as gone. How do I get these back? To get these files back, let's open up a web browser and head to the following website. You don't have to worry about typing in this website URL. Instead, you could just click into the description and then click on the link that I've included. It'll just make it easier for you. Once you land on the homepage for Recuva, this is where you could download one of the best file recovery tools. Now there are a few different versions of it. For now, I want to get the free version. That gives most of the functionality that we need. Once I click on download free version, it shows me what the 3 different options are. The free version does all of the file recovery that you need, and this one should be good enough in most cases. They also have a professional version, and then there's a bundle. The professional version gives you a few additional things, such as recovering files on virtual hard drives, automatic updates, and premium support. I love the tool so much that I'd probably be willing to even just pay for the professional just to support the company. If you go down, you can click on free download and that'll kick off the download process. Now under the free plan, I see a lot of red X's, but I'm still getting the advanced file recovery, so let's go with the free version. This kicks off the download process and I get this really cool arrow pointing down at the file that I need to click on to kick off the install. Let's click on that file. Next, I get a dialog telling me to click on install. Let's click on install. It's now gone through. The install was pretty quick. Once you're done installing, let's run Recuva. Once I click to run Recuva, this opens up the Recuva wizard and it's gonna walk me through the process of recovering files. Let's click on next. The next screen asks me what types of files I'm trying to recover. Now you could select things like pictures, music, documents, video, whatever files you happen to be looking for, select the file type. The reason they have you select the file type is it'll make it quicker to recover the files if it's only looking for a specific file type. I had images and I also had a Word document, so I'm just going to look for all files. Next, it asks me where the files were. Now, you could say, I don't know, and it'll look across your entire computer. If you do that, though, it'll take a little bit longer. So if you remember where the file was, it's best if you could specify where it was. I had my files on a USB thumb drive, so I'm going to click on in a specific location, and I'm going to choose my USB thumb drive. Now that I've selected my location, let's click on Next. That's all I needed to do. Rekuva is now ready to run and I can click on Start. Up above, there's a checkbox asking me if I want to do a deep scan. If for whatever reason it doesn't find the file that you're looking for, you can come back, run through the wizard again, and then try a deep scan to see if you'll find the file that you're looking for. I'm good with the quick scan, so let's click on Start. Check that out, it found all of my files. Here I have my Kevin Cookie Company Unicorn plan right at the top, and I have all of my JPEGs right here. To recover all of the files, let's click on this checkbox. This will check every single file. If you look over here, you'll see details related to each file. You'll see when it was last modified. You'll see the size of the file. You also see the state of the file, and these are all in excellent condition. I haven't been using the thumb drive. I haven't been writing anything else on it. So you'll see the comment here that says there are no overwritten clusters detected. Once again, when I was talking earlier and I said you delete a file, it makes that space available. So if you've been writing other things on your hard drive, chances are some of those clusters might be used for something else. In this case though, I didn't touch it and everything looks good. So let's click on Recover. Next, I could specify where I want to place my recovered files. I'm going to put them on the desktop. It now tells me that it recovered 8 files. And there were no partly recovered ones. They were all fully recovered. That's exactly what I wanted. Here too, I see the upgrade message, but I recovered all my files, so I'm going to click on OK. If I look at my desktop now, I can see all of the cookie images, and let's click into the Kevin Cookie Company Unicorn plan to see how we're planning to become a unicorn. Maybe I oversold it just a little bit. It's just a picture of a unicorn, but don't worry, in future tutorial videos, we'll continue pulling together our plan to turn the Kevin Cookie Company into a unicorn or a billion-dollar company. Alright, well that was a quick look at not only the strategic plans of the Kevin Cookie Company, but also how you can recover files on a Windows 10 PC. Rekuva works extremely well. It's served me very well in clutch situations in the past where I mistakenly deleted files. If Rekuva helped you to recover deleted files, please give this video a thumbs up. If you want to see future videos like this, hit that subscribe button. That way you'll get a notification anytime new content like this comes out. And lastly, if you want to see me cover any other topics in the future, leave a comment down below and I'll add it to my list of videos to create. All right, well, that's all I had for you today. I hope you enjoyed and I hope to see you next time. Bye.